So good day everyone. I am discussing about the first subtopic of our report in security metrics. And as we all know, information and data security are essential for businesses and organizations. In today's digital landscape, where almost all the operations rely on technology, which protecting sensitive data information is a top of priority. Security metrics play a crucial role in achieving this by providing measurable indicators to evaluate, monitor, and improve the overall security posture of an organization. These metrics ensure that information remains secured and hidden from unauthorized access, while offering valuable insights into the system's status through systematic data collection and analysis. Let us proceed by identifying the key security metrics that organizations should track. First is mean time to detect, or MTTD. This metric measures the time it takes for an organization to detect a data breach or security incident. The faster a breach is detected, the lower the potential risk and damage to the organization. Next is mean time to respond, or MTTR. Unlike MTTD, which focuses on detection, MTTR measures the time it takes to respond and mitigate a breach once it has occurred. A shorter MTTR indicates a more effective incident response process, reducing the overall impact of the breach. Another critical metric is unauthorized access attempts, one of the most common forms of data breaches. This refers to instances where intruders attempt to gain unauthorized access to the system, which can have severe consequences if successful. Organizations must also monitor the number of security incidents, which counts all reported incidents within a system. Tracking this metric is vital to developing strategies and action plans to address vulnerabilities and prevent future occurrences. In the last slide, the average cost per security incident is another metric that cannot be overlooked. This measures the financial damage resulting from a breach, including expenses of recovery, legal issues, and reputational harm. Finally, the percentage of employees who complete security training is equally important. A well-trained workforce within a thorough understanding of security practices can significantly reduce the risk of breaches and enhance the organization's overall security framework. And we have five security performance indicators when it comes to security metrics. First is the level of preparedness, to keep us prepared and aware of what's happening in the system real time. We should keep our system monitored all the time to avoid unexpected attacks. Next is unidentified devices on internal networks, to monitor which devices have access to the networks so that unnecessary devices are observed because it might be harmful for the system. The other one is intrusion attempts. We all know that all the attempts are counts as attacks. even if it failed. So we need to be prepared and have daily reports. Next one is security incidents. Like the last key performance, we need to have reports to know all the incidents happened to respond on how to avoid and treat those weaknesses in the system. And lastly, access management, which we all know essential for the security to keep the sensitive and confidential data of the system. And these are all the factors to keep in mind to avoid data breaches. Now for the challenges. We have defining relevant and meaningful metrics, which is a challenge because it is difficult to choose the metrics that are truly meaningful and align with business goals. The other one is data collection and security, because collecting accurate and consistent data can be difficult due to possible insufficient automation. Next is establishing clear ownership and accountability, which can be hard to determine who is responsible for the given task. Another one is lack of standardization, because in security metrics, there are no standardization. It only depends on what the system needs and is for the organization team to find out. And lastly is communicating to stakeholders, because not all stakeholders has the knowledge to manage security metrics. And these are all only challenges and doesn't necessarily mean that security metrics cannot operate and apply when this happens. Despite these challenges, it is important to note that they do not render security metrics ineffective or incapable. Instead, these challenges highlight areas where organizations can focus their efforts to improve implementation and maximize the benefits of using security metrics. By addressing these challenges proactively, organizations can build a robust security framework that protects sensitive data and ensures long-term success. That concludes the discussion of this first topic, and thank you. And that is for our first subtopic of the report.